गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट। टुडे इन क्लास 5 आई विल कंटिन्यू इन द चैप्टर रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटीज ऑफ अ सिटीजन इन अ डेमोक्रेटिक पॉलिटी। एंड आई हैड स्टार्टेड डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द फंडामेंटल ड्यूटीज। ओके, मोस्ट ऑफ दीज आर फंडामेंटल ड्यूटीज एंड अप टू थ्री पॉइंट्स वी हैव डिस्कस्ड। नाउ द फोर्थ वन, डिफेंड द कंट्री एंड रेंडर नेशनल सर्विस वेन कॉल्ड अपॉन टू डू सो। सो इट इज़ आवर रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी ऑफ एवरी सिटीजन ऑफ आवर कंट्री टू डिफेंड द कंट्री। वेन एवर द कंट्री इज इन ट्रबल, वी शुड बी रेडी टू स्टैंड एंड प्रोटेक्ट द कंट्री, डिफेंड द कंट्री फ्रॉम द एनिमी एंड रेंडर नेशनल सर्विस। ओके, to do something for the good of the nation, national service when called upon, whenever the country need our help and country call for our service, we should be ever ready to go and serve the nation, mother nation, and called up to do so. Then promote harmony and the spirit of common brotherhood amongst all the people of India. Okay, that is since India is a very big country, seventh largest country in the world and second most populous country in the world, largest democracy and diversity. Okay, India is a country with so many religion. People of all religion stay in this country. Okay, Hindu, Muslim, Christian, Sikh and many more. So there should be brotherhood among all the people. Okay, we should feel like belonging to the same nation. We should be ready to help each other and work shoulder to shoulder to take the country on the path of development and progress. Okay, and this can only come by promoting a spirit of brotherhood, common brotherhood and harmony, love among each other. We should respect each other's religion. We should respect each other's culture. Okay, then only we can strive for brotherhood. Okay, so to promote harmony and the spirit of common brotherhood among all the people of India. Then next one is value and preserve the rich heritage of India's composite culture. So India has got a composite culture, that is a mixture of different culture. Okay, because we know that in history if we see, then many invaders, they came to India and they settled in India and they brought their own culture, like the Mughals, or before the Mughal, the Turkish, before the Turkish, the Sakas. Okay, so in this way, different invaders, they all came to India and they brought their own culture and their culture fused with the Indian culture, mixture. Okay, so a composite culture developed. So we should value and preserve the rich heritage of India's composite culture. Then protect and improve the natural environment. Okay, environment plays a very important role, we know. Okay, and so it is our responsibility to protect and improve the natural environment. We should not destroy the environment. So we should polluting the land or water or air. Okay, so we should preserve the environment. And one thing is, for preserving the environment, you have to plant more and more trees. And we should not cut the trees. Then develop the scientific temper, humanism and the spirit of inquiry and reform. That is each citizen of India or students, so they should develop scientific temper. Science means related to science, reason. Okay, not to accept anything blindly, but rather there should be a reason behind it. Why? Always the question should be there, why, how, okay, all these things. Then develop the scientific temper, humanism, that is harmony, cooperation, okay, all such, and the spirit of inquiry, always inquire the things, okay, without inquiry, don't accept anything blindly, what is good, what is bad, why it is bad, why it is good, okay, all such things. So spirit of inquiry, in inquiry, always you ask the question why and how, and reform. Then safeguard public property. Whatever public property is there, park or railway station or bus stand or road. Okay, we should safeguard, protect it, not to destroy it. Safeguard public property and abjure violence. That is, to abstain, to keep oneself away from violence, not to participate in violence. If violence is taking place, you should not be a part of that. Rather, you should try to stop that violence. Okay, so safeguard public property and abjure violence. Then strive towards excellence in all spheres of individual and collective activity. Okay, so one should always strive, that is struggle towards excellence, to be the best. Okay, to achieve 100%. Okay, excellence in all spheres of individual, all spheres, academic, okay, social life, economy, in everything, in all spheres of individual's life and collective activity also, where you are staying collectively in the group. Okay, so all the people in the group should work hard to achieve this excellence. Then provide opportunities for education to her or his child or ward between the age of 6 and 14 years. This is the now a fundamental right. Okay, that is primary education in between the age to 6 to 14 is made compulsory, and it is a fundamental right to education. Then obey the law of the country and pay taxes honestly and regularly. Okay, so we should also obey the law of the country, then only you can become an ideal and responsible citizen, law-abiding, okay, by following the law of the country. And also pay tax, okay, because every person have got some income, okay, through business or through job, and so they should pay taxes honestly and regularly. Then use the voting rights very carefully. Whenever voting is done, you should be very careful in choosing the correct candidate. Okay, not give just giving vote to anyone. Okay, but to give to that person who is good, who can do something good for the society, for the good of your society, then only you vote for that person. So as students, we should also devote time to our studies and should strictly follow the instruction given by our teacher. So you as a student, it is your, what is your duty? Your duty is now to study. To study and to follow the instructions given by your parents, by your teachers. Okay, so in your home also, you must be knowing that all the time your parents must be giving you that you sit and study, you do your homework. Okay, you should not fight with your brother or sister or in the society with your friend. Okay, so these are the instructions which are given, and you should follow those instructions. We should keep our school, home, and neighborhood neat, clean, and green. That is, wherever we know that cleanliness is next to godliness. Okay, so wherever you stay, whether it is school or home or neighborhood, you should keep it neat and clean, and also green by planting more trees, because environment depends on greenery. Okay, if more plants are there, the environment will be good. So today we have completed this chapter, Responsibilities of a Citizen in a Democratic Polity. If you have any doubt, you can ask in the online class. Then exercise, question answer, you do it by yourself. Okay, and PDF file I will be sending you. Those PDF file you write in your copy. Okay, thank you. Take care. Bye.